Hey everyone, I bought a new gadget for my home lab just this week and I wanted to share it with all of you. It is this SMD Rework Station. It is a hot air gun and it is ATTEN ST-862D model number. Now, I will admit right away that I'm neither passionate or great at soldering stuff. My main aim is to have the prototype PCB or even the perf board soldered just enough to make it work. And what excites me most is to have that prototype in my hand. For me, soldering is a means to an end. And I do want to try out the SMT assembly service offered by some providers. These services are becoming more and more accessible and affordable for small volume manufacturing. But I definitely believe that we should know how to do soldering by ourselves for two big reasons. Number one, no matter what we do, the first or the second version, the iteration of our PCB will need some rework or bodging, and that's where some kind of manual soldering will come into usefulness. The second reason is to have a very healthy appreciation of what actually goes behind the scenes of assembling a PCB, whether it is manual or by a machine. So why did I decide to buy this SMD rework station? Well, the PCBs that I'm currently making are moving more and more towards SMD. In fact, I used to make through-hole PCBs. I do not anymore. For many of these components, such as 0805, the simplest one, I can already use my soldering iron. But for some SMDs, there are pads underneath these components. For example, this temperature sensor, SI7021 from Scilabs, has a non-standard packaging. Now, the second reason was to desolder these SMDs, especially after the first revision or the second revision when I spot some errors in the hardware soldering or I need to change out some components. Many times I had a faulty component soldered and had no way of desoldering it, either with my soldering iron, the soldering wick, or even the desoldering pump. So I was on a hunt for a hot air gun. Now, I already have a soldering station, so I did not want those stations that come with the hot air gun and the soldering station. I required just a hot air gun. And I was definitely looking for something that was safe because after all, we are dealing with high temperature and also not too expensive. I mean, the ones that I saw are fairly expensive, going from $500, $600, $700. I really wanted in the low hundreds, like $100 or $200 maximum. So I did some sleuthing on the internet and thankfully found Louis Rossman talking about this particular model by ATTEN. Please do watch this video as he does some live comparison of time of desoldering some components from PCBs between a more expensive quick model and this one by ATTEN. But of course, after making my mind that I wanted to buy this ATTEN model, I had to ensure that I could actually get this particular model delivered to my hometown in Singapore. Thankfully, I found this exact model on AliExpress that could be delivered to me. I also chose the option AC220 EU plug and made sure some bent nozzles were part of the delivery as Louis Rossman kept recommending it. The delivery was super fast. I ordered it on 29 July and got it delivered at home on 5th August. The total cost was about $155. So I want to go through some features with you. Now, a hot air gun is as simple as it can be. It can either range in the temperature or in the airflow, how heavy or slow the airflow will be. Now, I'm definitely not an expert in using a hot air gun, but I found this model fairly intuitive and easy to operate. So I keep the hot air gun at home inside the cupboard using the same packaging it came with. Now, out of the box, it comes with the manual, the power cable, and the stand to hold the actual handpiece hot air gun. The handpiece, which is the hot air gun, is attached with the main body through piping and it cannot be taken out. I like this. I think it's quite safe to do so. The model also comes with lots of nozzles, mainly two different types, the straight nozzle and the bent nozzle with various sizes. Now, I made sure the bent nozzles were shipped to me as recommended by Louis Rossman. Putting on the nozzle is pretty easy. Just slip it in on the end of the handpiece. Now over to actually making it work. To start the hot air gun, you first power it on with this switch at the bottom. Then you simply need to lift it up from the stand and press this blue button on the handpiece. And I like this safety feature because it is not going to start heating up right away when we take it from the stand. So let's first start with the airflow controls on the left. I'm going to increase it from 1% all the way to 50% with up and down arrow buttons on the left. And let's decrease the airflow now. The temperature can also be adjusted easily with the up and down arrow buttons to the right. And to cool down, we can either press the blue button on the handpiece or we can simply put it back on the stand. It will automatically cool down, and while it does so, we can see the temperature on the screen coming down as well. It will slowly cool down to about 100 degrees and after that it will stop the hot air from blowing. Now I have yet to try this hot air gun for actual soldering, maybe because I already have a soldering station, but I did see many resources online that were using solder paste and then blowing the hot air gun over SMD components. And some of these videos have really high quality images for us to actually see what's going on. So one of them is by Great Scotts, where he actually talks generally about soldering, whether it's through-hole components, and then goes on to explain SMD. And finally with the hot air gun. Another one goes through the entire process of soldering using the solder paste and a very small SMD components on an entire PCB. Now I did try desoldering as well. Here I am using the bent nozzle with the temperature set to 320 degrees and a low airflow of 5%. Within a minute or so, slightly below 60 seconds, the 0805 resistor was off the PCB. The last thing that I tried with this hot air gun was heat shrink tubing. The sleeve was rated at 125 degrees, but such a temperature with the hot air gun didn't really shrink the sleeve at first. Then I set the temperature to 200 degrees and airflow to 10%. The tubing shrank within half a minute of blowing the hot air. Maybe a high temperature would have been faster, but I didn't want to overheat stuff. Before having this machine, I really needed an access to some kind of hardware lab that is outside my home. And obviously now that is not so convenient. And looking at the prices and the size of many models, they were either too expensive, too bulky, or came with more features than I needed personally. And therefore, this model really works for my use case. Overall, I'm pretty excited to own this. It is a multipurpose machine that does the job of soldering, desoldering, or even heat shrinking. So I'm pretty excited to kind of use this machine to make more prototypes, PCB, or even do some soldering rework. So thanks for watching this short review of this SMD Rework station, and I'll see you in the next video.